Thank you very much. International Foundation, Sri Chandan Brahma, Honorable Minister Transport, we have just left this dais. Mr. Pranab Gogoi, Honorable Minister Assam. Dr. Hema Prabha Saikia, Chairman ATDC. All the distinguished members sitting on the dais, coming from different countries, from India, all the distinguished scholars sitting in the hall, coming from different countries, Myanmar, Thailand, China and other countries, all the distinguished personalities from Assam, India sitting in this hall, ladies and gentlemen, indeed, I am overwhelmed to speak in front of you. On this similar occasion, a few years back, all our tribe brethren sitting here, some of them were also present there in the Yunnan province. I was invited to attend a seminar, and when I spoke in my own tongue, in my own Thai Khamti language, everybody became overwhelmed and everybody had given a big applause and a big clap that when we understand each other in our own tongue. I would like to say that our Thai language is a tonal language. With this slight tonal differences, all the same, I had gone to Thailand, I spoke with them. When I closely hear them, it's almost the same. They use a lot of Sanskrit. We use a lot of Pali. You see, Pad Thai, when we say Kai, it's chicken for the Thai people. When I say Kai, a little bit different. When Thai people hear Kai, what is this Kai? They don't understand. But when I say Kai, they understand. It's like that tonal. Otherwise, with the little tonal differences, all our languages are understandable. Today, the Thai Ahom language has become dormant. But it is still there in the manuscript, still is a live language. So I believe with the efforts of all our Thai scholars here, we can revive this language also back. Today we are fortunate that His Excellency, the Ambassador of Thailand is present here. He has spoken in length about the bilateral relation, the trade relation, and the what in future we could do for our the social link, for our social relation, for our the economic relation, for our trade relation, for the improvement of our economy of the Northeast. First of all, he said that the route, the mapping connection infrastructure has to be developed first. Unless we have the road communication, we cannot have this mapping connection. Chowlung Sukapha, years back, he had come through that Pangsau Pass. Today, many people do not understand what is Pangsau Pass. Even we do not understand what is Pangsau Pass. That is why I always try to make them understand that Pangsau Pass is nothing but it is a Thai language. Pang. Pang means it's a field, it's a great, big field. Sau means whole. The Thai, the great Chowlung Sukapha, when he came, he made it a transit camp there. And Pad Kai, he had a slave. Pad Kai means, Pad means at a stroke you cut the throat of the chicken. Kai means chicken. Pad Kai. Nong Yang, lake of no return. The people say lake of no return. Why it is called lake of no return? Many people do not understand lake of no return. We call Nong Yang. Nong means pond. It's a big pond. Nong Yang. Yang means sticky. So maybe those days, During the Second World War, when people go there rushing, during the wartime they feel thirsty and all, they go running to drink water and all this, they do not come back. Maybe that also people think when I ask the senior people. And many scholars believe that this Mr. Stillwell had adopted the same alignment, the Chaulung Sukhava had adopted that alignment that Stillwell wrote. My grandfather had traveled from the same road just after the end of the Second World War with two villages. Those days the villages could cross, now we cannot cross. Footmarks has to be, people have to come on footmarks on the Myanmar side, no road connectivity. On the Indian side, we are fortunate that from Lido to the Pangsau Pass, the road is built and new this highway is being constructed. Now it is fully, you see, all weather road is being constructed. So only our government has to build a road. On the other side, if need be, our government can go inside the Myanmar and build the road on the other side. This way we can bring about a mapping connection. Since I don't have much of the time, I don't want to share my thought in the extemporal form. So what I have brought in the written form, I will read in front of all of you. The slogan Lookist is not a new concept to India. Though the Lookist policy grows popular among the intellectuals in India and the Northeast India, recently it gets more momentum among the cherished circle, yet it was an old-time concept in India. Even in the pre-Christian era, Indian merchants with religious and literary circle marched or rode up to Far East like Japan, Korea, Vietnam, and they were very commonly went to Cambodia, Malaysia, Myanmar, Thailand, Laos, and Southern and Central China. They named those places as Kombos, Kosambi, Videha, Champa, Jambudipa, Suvarnabhumi, and the local people of Southeast as China, Korea, Japan named their places as Champa, Ayodhya, Ramapur, Amarapura, Suvarnakhetra, Mithila, Shyamdesh, etc. Indian culture, language and religion had spread in these areas hundreds of years ago. Before Buddhism, Hinduism had spread and along with Indian Brahmi script had moved from Indian soil. Ganesh, Hanuman, Vishnu, Shiva, Saraswati and such other Hindu gods and goddesses are popular deities till now in these areas. If you visit Thailand, you will see a lot of Ganesha in the Thai temple and other all these deities. Buddhism was spread to the Southeast Asian soil and Western and Eastern China and to the Far East countries. Again, there were trade and cultural links from even Western countries like Rome to even Chinese capital 1,000 years ago. And there were links of at least two land silk routes, one through Patkai Hills and another through Manipur and Kanchanaburi. In this way, land routes had connection to old Mandalay, Takong Kingdom, and the Kunming of Yunnan province. By sea also, there is to be connection from India and Sri Lanka to even Far East countries. In the medieval period too, there were connections and trade and exchange of languages, literature, culture, were there in between India, especially Northeast India and Southeast Asian countries. After the devastating effect of the World War, the trade and cultural connections had almost lost its old gather. The need to look this is a recent development in India and even Northeast part of India, and it gains momentum during the recent years. The basic concept of policy of India and Northeast state of India is most praiseworthy and benevolent for both sides. It is now well known that the ethnics of Northeast India have got similar ethnicity.